these are the kind of things that we always want to share with the rest of the world. It just couldn't get better than that. And it will never get better than that. This cat is a very special cat. This mom, she's very, very clever. She's a very good mom. And she actually interacts with many other cats of this neighborhood. I like to think that this place is a cat neighborhood. They all know each other. Most of the things that we've been able to see here in Torres del Paine, they've taken us by surprise. As a very social animal, not like the solitary cat that they are supposed to be. They all have different interactions. Some of them are better than others, and there's constant overlaps. My name is Rene. I am a wildlife filmmaker, but I worked as a guide here in Torres del Paine National Park many years ago. And that was the beginning. That was the beginning for my personal story with this place and for my story with these animals, this story with these cats. We as a team, we know certain territories, who usually you'll find in this territory, who you'll find in this other territory. Very often we see where those territories overlap, and that's where we find interactions. That's where we see very unusual things. We've been lucky enough to see massive groups of pumas together, 8 pumas together. We've seen interactions between different males. We've seen interactions between mothers with different litters, different generations. They've shown us things that they are not supposed to happen. They've shown us a secret life. And those are the things that happen in a place that is very healthy. It's a very healthy ecosystem. These pumas don't have any competition. We are not a threat as humans, so that's also another extra layer of protection for them. But they don't have any wolves, they don't have any bears. So they are the kings and the queens of this place. So they live in a very peaceful way. The fact that they have so many guanacos and so much food brings every tension to the lowest level. It's not worth it to fight for a kill. It's not worth it to fight with another cat for the food. You just share, and they share kills. There's many different ways of finding these cats. First, paying attention to your surrounding, to the environment itself. Guanacos are giving alarm calls when they see a cat. A guanaco is doing an alarm call when it has the cat on its eye, when it's looking at it. If the puma goes down, hides, camouflages itself under a bush, the guanaco stops doing the alarm call. So as long as a guanaco is doing an alarm call, very, very fast, we need to go with the binos and start checking. That's the only way of getting tuned to the environment, walking around in silence, just hearing for the alarm calls, sitting down on the top of a hill, watching with the binos in all different directions. So you're constantly scanning the area, just watching things. We have the shot over. The shot over is a camera, an amazing piece of technology with this long lens inside on a big gimbal. So everything is very stabilized. You can see far away. So it's almost like having binos constantly on your eyes on a big screen inside of the vehicle. And whenever the shot over finds something, immediately we tell the rest of the crew. We have the movie, which is a really cool piece of gear. It's basically the camera on the body of Ben or Eli walking around with this piece of gear. It's pretty funny to watch. It brings other feeling. You can walk with the cats. You can follow them when they are stalking, and gives you very intimate moments. You can feel being part of the action. Our goal is to film natural behavior. That's natural history. We need to tell the story of these animals without interfering with their life, without bothering them, without motivating any sort of behavior from them. But if they want to get close to you, they can. And then the drone. If you don't know how to use the drone properly, it's dangerous for the cats, for interrupting whatever behavior is happening. That's why you need people that not only are really good by using the drone, but you need people that understand the natural behavior of the cats. Because you have to be very patient. You can't just go and fly and do whatever you want with the drone. As long as you keep the distance, you can do really interesting things with the drone. You can film them on top of rocks in the most cinematographic ways. It's beautiful. So the drone is crucial. and the drone, and the guys using the drone, they have vast experience with wildlife. And certainly what we can get with the drone are things that we could only dream of years ago. The importance of these areas, as protected as they are now, it's crucial. It's probably one of the last few wild places left on this planet, the whole of it. Yes, there's cities, there's little towns, but most of Patagonia is still wild. Most of Patagonia is still unexplored. And the natural areas, like national parks, they need our protection. They need us to be paying attention to them. All of these areas, they, in a certain way, they are a guarantee that we can connect this massive piece of land. Biological corridors, there's things going on in there that no one has researched properly yet. They mean so much for humanity. The world needs more wild spaces. The world needs more nature. We've always been part of something bigger. And things like what has been happening here, they need to be replicated all around the world when possible. Governments, authorities, locals, we need to show this nature to the world. We need to get them motivated to visit. We need to get them motivated to get outside of their homes. We need to be back in nature as humanity. That's probably the best solution for most of our problems.